Learning a new web framework takes a lot of effort. Reading just one book on React is 307 pages. Doesn't it sound appealing to just remove these bloated frameworks? So, is it then worth the effort of learning about this new web framework, FastHTML? Or will it soon be also forgotten like so many others before it? Before I give my opinion about FastHTML, let's go through the what, the why, the architecture, compatibility, customization, ideal use cases, communities, and resources available for FastHTML. All that goodies that gives a hint about the future for this framework. So let's start with, what is FastHTML? It is in fact a new Python library that creates a web server, HTML and HTX support. With that, you can build modern reactive web applications. So what is the original purpose of FastHTML? It wants to replace the big and bulky web frameworks like Angular and React with a lightweight one. Write less code and get more done. Move all transport into an HTML language. Moving on to some key features. How will app performance be affected by FastHTML? It moves the computation updates of HTML and HTMX from the client to the server. On the server, where there is often more power available. The actual rendering of this HTML will be the same in both cases, done by the client. I've been looking around for some performance evaluations and really seen nothing much published as of yet. If you've seen anyone, please comment in the comments. I would love to see some. So, what about ease of use when it comes to FastHTML? First of all, it's easily installed with a pip command, as so many other Python libraries. All code you write is written in Python. App code is supposed to stay small and easy to get an overview of. But let's keep a minus in our heads here. The coder actually needs to understand both HTML and HTMX details to reap all the benefits of this framework. Then, what core technologies are FastHTML built on? It is based on the Python libraries UVCorn, Starlet, and HTMX. In case you would like to dig deeper into those. And what about compatibility? Well, FastHTML, as it is a Python library, will run on anything that supports Python. The HTMX parts works with any browser that supports JavaScript and XML HTTP requests. And that is about all of them, even some of the Internet Explorer ones. You can also use HTMX alongside other JavaScript libraries if you want. That increases compatibility. Now, what about the actual architecture for using FastHTML? The library FastHTML contains predefined HTML functions or components, if you will, defined in Python. That speeds up coding of your web pages tremendously. The HTMX parts is added by defining certain arguments to the components if you want them. But if you're just using HTML, you don't need to define them at all. Now, shifting HTML generation from the client to the server should speed up execution compared to React applications. But we're still waiting for evaluations, performance evaluations on this part. Now, how flexible is FastHTML? Can you customize your application? Yeah, you can extend the predefined set of components with your own custom components. This could come in handy if you, for instance, are using your own HTML tags. Another way to expand is to extend with another JavaScript library, if you wish. So, what are some stated benefits of using FastHTML compared to traditional frameworks? For the first, reduced need to transfer bulky web framework code over to the client, also executing it there. So we have both load times and execution time in the client. Second, all communication is HTML or HTMX. No need for JSON transcoding of data. On introduction of new coders, there's no need to study a bulky 300 pages book from O'Reilly about React, for instance. And for the last, all code can be in Python. That is a good thing, at least according to me. Then, what about developer productivity if you're using FastHTML? Now, all can be put into one file. That is very efficient for a small team. But maybe it could be a hard thing for larger teams. All in one file means also it will break the MVC or Model View Controller model that many are using. Or can it be maintained as well? We need to look into this later on. And what are some ideal use cases for FastHTML? Typical use cases is not really clear yet, but we can think about some of them. Definitely, we're talking about early prototypes, MVPs, testing servers, and such small applications. I also heard about the ability to handle streaming data, and that enables dashboards as well. So let's keep an eye on who jumps on this FastHTML ship and starts using it officially. Then what about communities around FastHTML? Well, the GitHub that develops FastHTML has got 48 contributors. There is also a Discord for developers and users. Link in description to both of them. And what resources are available for users of FastHTML? Of course, you can get the code directly from GitHub. And there is also a gallery of ready-made components that you can just download. Link to those in description. And the future. What is known about the roadmap for developing FastHTML platform? It is an open source project, but it doesn't have any published time plans at all. Some areas, like authentication and database integration, is still under work, so it's open to suggestions and some help in these areas. So to start summing up the pros and cons. First, the pros. It is a new approach to single page application. I kind of like it. Probably faster load times than the behemoths. It's an easy to start. Small projects in it. Let's try that out. It is Python everything. What's not to like? It's supposed to give compact code. Perfect for small teams. Let's look into that one as well. And then the cons I can see right now. It is open source only, so there is no company backing it up at the moment at least. We'll see what happens on that one. There is not a full coverage of what a web framework needs yet. Auth and databases are under work. That can be fixed. It is also, I'm sorry to say, breaking the MVC that many have organizations around. So the question is how to make larger teams divide the tasks between them and how to get that into the code. Can be fixed, I guess. Let's see. It also requires a deep HTML, HTMX knowledge by the coders. On the other side, we don't need to know the React or Angular framework knowledges, so it's just another thing to learn. Hopefully, I'd say a smaller thing. Styling your FastHTML application is a bit obscure today. I'm not sure if it is a tutorial or if there is a missing tool. I'll be looking into that part later on. So finally, my conclusions. This framework can go anywhere. From dying in obscurity to becoming a major player in the web framework industry. I like the basics of it, and I will make some deeper tests myself later on. So even with all its current limiting factors, I'm excited about it. Are you? Now, do subscribe to get more content about FastHTML. When they are published, they will show up in suggested here. So, click it and I will see you in there.